next heading, condition for spontaneity. Condition for spontaneity. The first one is energy, delta H. Okay, condition for spontaneity, the first one is energy, write down. Exothermic process, in exothermic process, the energy releases, and hence it is spontaneous. Okay, next line. There are,
same point.
Next line is this only. There are few processes which is endothermic in nature, but is spontaneous. There are few processes which is endothermic in nature, but is spontaneous. So exothermic is so clear that we are going towards less energy, so stable and process takes place. There are few endothermic reactions which are endothermic but is spontaneous. For example, you write down this reaction, conversion of this liquid into gas. Okay. Conversion of liquid into gas. Decomposition of CaCO3. Right? It also requires energy, and this dissociates into CaO. Sorry, it is solid. This is also solid. And this is gas, CO2.
Sir, burning of fuel is also
interesting. But burning of fuel, it just need an initiation. In this also is not required. Once, see, actually when any reaction takes place, right? So, see, in this room also we have oxygen and carbon. But the reaction is not taking place. Carbon plus CO2. O2, CO2 form, because for any reaction we require some minimum amount of energy. That energy, once you provide, it takes place. It goes on its own. And that minimum energy is activation energy, we call it. Okay? So, for example, like I said, carbon and oxygen is present, but these two are not reacting. Because the minimum amount of energy that is required is not here. When you provide that energy, reaction takes place. Uske baad nahi chahiye, suppose kuch. That is not formation. Formation in that we will discuss. Thermochemistry will cut it. Okay, so this, you provide heat into it. It converts back into this. So point is, this process is a spontaneous. It is an spontaneous process. And the factor is not because of energy. Because we are providing energy into it. The factor is randomness. We define this process, why this process is spontaneous, is because of randomness. So in the product side, we have gaseous molecules, which is more random. Right? So what we say, the entropy of this delta S is greater than zero. Entropy, we'll see what is entropy.
Same thing for
H2. For H2 also we have the same thing. Gas, more entropy. Right? So process either goes towards the lesser energy state or more randomness, more entropy state.
So why do you have delta? Is it that enthalpy?
Yeah, energy means the enthalpy, the energy which is associated with that process.
So, but we said that enthalpy is energy only when external pressure is a constant.
No. Enthalpy is also the energy content of the system. The system, the energy associated with the system is the enthalpy of that system. So it is not that, we write here as delta H, right? Like there I have written, delta H. It is the energy contained of the system. Yeah, that energy which is associated with the system. We write a delta H, enthalpy of the system, but you can also consider as U. That is not internal energy, okay? That is what we need here. So this two process takes place because the entropy is increasing this side. Energy it is consuming, endothermic, but since the entropy is increasing, that's why this process is taking place, right? So the driving force for this process is entropy, not energy. Process takes place when we are going towards lesser energy state or more randomness, towards more randomness. Okay, then only it is possible, right? So now to understand this randomness, we have a term given and that we call it as entropy. So next you write down entropy. Entropy is represented by S. Just you need to know, more randomness, more entropy. So if I write down, if I compare the entropy of a gaseous system and entropy of a liquid system, which one will have more entropy? Gas. More randomness. entropy of a liquid system and entropy of a solid system. Obviously, liquid will have more entropy. Entropy of gas and again entropy of solid, entropy of gases. Right? So, lesser intermolecular force, more randomness, more entropy. Okay? Definition of this you write down. It is also a state function, like internal energy and all. Okay? State function depends upon initial and final state, not the path followed. Okay? So write down, entropy, it is a thermodynamic state quantity. It is a thermodynamic state quantity which gives us the idea about the randomness or disorderness. Disorderness of the system. It is an extensive property and depends upon initial and final state. Right? So delta S will write entropy at final state minus entropy at the initial state. Unit of entropy is what? Unit. If you have any doubt, you can compare with this. This formula you will memorize. Okay. All the use values. Delta G is equal to delta S minus T delta S. This energy, this should also be energy, right? The whole T del S term should also be energy. Delta S is what? Energy per this temperature. So it is joule per Kelvin. Calorie, anything you can write. Okay? Next you write down. Next line. Mathematically it is defined as
delta S is the heat content of the system. Per temperature.
Per
unit temperature.
Delta H.
Delta S.
No, delta H is randomness.
How is it
changed before? Abhi main tumko energy dunga, more or less. So you are in more random state. That is the energy per unit temperature, right? So when you provide the energy to the system, that will also change the temperature. Internal energy increases. So ratio of that is nothing but the entropy. It's very typical actually, entropy if you try to define. Just one word you can say randomness or disorderness. That's why I have given this comparison. If the molecule has more tendency to move, it is in more random state. That's how we do it. Okay? So, write down, mathematically it is defined as the integral of all the terms involved in heat exchange. Mathematically it is defined as the integral of all the terms involved in heat exchange, that is Q in bracket you write down, divided by the absolute temperature in reversible isothermal process. Okay? So delta S is defined by, mathematically it is defined by dS is equals to dQ reversible divided by T at integral of this. Okay, this is the mathematical definition of this. So if you find out this, it becomes delta S, the change in entropy, divided by 1 by T dQ reversible integral. Reversible isothermal process. Okay? Now if energy absorbed by the system, it means Q reversible is positive or negative?
Positive. Delta S has to be positive.
By the system. It means Q is positive greater than 0. It means delta S is also Positive, this means what? Entropy? Entropy increases. Delta S positive means entropy increases. If heat release or energy released by the system, energy released by the system, so Q is what? Less than zero. Delta S is also less than zero, and hence entropy decreases. Okay. See, all the energy terms involve a reversible process. All will add. That's why it is. It is nothing but Q reversible by T. For this expression, if you solve this, you can write this also. Right. You can write. Point is, all kind of energy will add first and then divide.
Okay, fine. Let
us
just be right.
Okay, I know next. If the heat exchange is possible, then we can write delta as total. Change in entropy, total entropy is equals to the change in entropy of the system plus the change in entropy of surrounding. Okay? Total delta S is equals to delta S of the system plus delta S of the surrounding. If system receives energy, its entropy increases. Delta S will be positive. Delta S greater than zero. And for delta S of the system greater than zero and delta S of surrounding less than zero. Right? If system receives energy, its entropy increases and surrounding's entropy decreases. Delta S less than zero for surrounding, greater than zero for system. Okay? Next write down.
So is delta S total always zero?
Hmm?
Delta S total always zero?
No, delta S total always greater than zero. It always increases. At equilibrium it is zero. Right? At equilibrium it is zero. Entropy change in isothermal reversible process. Entropy change in isothermal reversible process. Write down into this. Suppose the system absorbs Q amount of heat. Suppose the system, write down here, if the system absorbs Q amount of heat, amount of heat at temperature T. Okay, so delta S of system is what? It equals to plus Q by T. Its entropy increases, right? And delta S of surroundings is what? Minus Q by T. Total entropy change is what? Delta S of system plus delta S of surrounding. And that will be the total S, delta S will be zero in this case. So for reversible isothermal process, the total change in entropy is equals to zero. reversible isothermal process. Okay, reversible isothermal process, delta S total is equals to zero. Similarly, if the process is reversible adiabatic, since we have adiabatic process, so Q reversible is what? Zero. Adiabatic process we have, Q reversible zero. So again delta S is what? Delta S will be zero. Not that important. Next write down entropy change. In irreversible process. Entropy change in irreversible process. Suppose the system here is at temperature T1 and the surroundings at T2. And what again we are assuming, T1 is greater than T2. Two different temperature we have, so T1 is greater than T2. So system has at higher temperature, so this will lose energy, heat, and the surroundings gains, right? So delta S of the system is what? Minus Q by T1, can I write this? It loses Q amount of heat and surroundings gains Q amount of heat, right? It loses energy, so minus Q by T1. Why T1? Because it is at T1 temperature. Delta S of surroundings is what? Plus Q by T2. So what is the total entropy change? Delta S total. We'll add this to, and that will be Q by T1 plus Q by T2. So this becomes Q
T1 minus T2.
Alright, T1 minus T2, correct. Yeah.
So what's the formula for it? Is it Q by T? What's
the formula? See, delta S formula is what? Mathematical definition is what? Entropy change. Q reversible by T. Okay? It means in reversible process, whatever the change in heat we have, energy, that divided by the absolute temperature. Right? So all these are for reversible process. Okay? But this we are assuming for irreversible process. Similar kind of formula we have. Since it loses energy, Q amount, so minus Q by T1. Heat releases by the system, minus, negative. When this accepts the same amount of heat, it becomes Q by T2. So delta S total is this plus this. This two will add and we'll get this. Now T1 minus T2 is what? Negative or positive? Positive, because T1 is greater than T2. So what we can say, since this term is greater than 0, so delta S total is what? Delta S total is greater than 0. Even if you assume T2 greater than T1, then also you'll get the same expression. Delta S total is greater than 0. If it is T2, then this loses heat.
Oh, then that will
be. Right, so you'll get the same expression here. So it does not matter that whether this temperature is high or this temperature is high. Right? What we can conclude here, that in irreversible process, the delta S total always increases greater than 0, positive. So write down into this. For irreversible process, entropy always increases. Entropy always increases.
That's because H always increases.
So,
yes.
So that gives free energy can be less than
T. Can be less than T. That means,
so in an isolated system, entropy only increases.
Entropy of the universe is actually increasing. But isolated system does not interact at all. There is no exchange of heat. So isolated system, if you see delta S, if you see, it will be zero.
In an isolated
system. There is no exchange of heat, no.
But in an open system, it
depends. Open system, it depends whether it is taking heat or releasing heat. Okay, isolated system means what? The boundary is completely isolated. It is not interacting with the surroundings. So there is no heat exchange. So delta S will be zero in that.
Sir, but you don't know whether it's interacting or not because.
No, when you say system is isolated, it means it is not interacting.
So its
boundary is isolated.
So within the system, what if you had some?
That's another case. If you are assuming, sir, that within the system there is some mixing of gases, gases particles are mixing. So because of that mixing, the entropy will increase. Understood. So condition, if you put, the conclusion will be different. Okay. If you have a system, right, system completely isolated system, then this for this delta S will be zero. There is no increase in entropy, provided that what that we are considering within the system that there's no reaction, there's no mixing, right? But when we have gaseous particles, and if it is mixing, then delta S will be greater than zero. Okay. Understood this? Aage bade, fine. Understood? Okay. Doubt? Doubt? Okay. Understood this? So when the system, within the system, with gases are mixing, then delta S greater than zero. If it is not for isolated system, it change in entropy is always zero. Right? Now there are like to calculate this entropy, we have certain formulas. Okay, that formula you have to directly apply. I just give you the formula. So write down the first thing, calculation of entropy. You write down. Calculation of entropy. First case, when temperature and volume are variable. When T and V are variable, the formula of delta S is equals to 2.303 NCV log of T2 by T1 NCV, right? NCV log of T2 by T1 plus 2.303 NR log of derivation you want. Derivation?
No.
Kar sakte hai, I think. We can derive it also. But that is not required.
Okay.
Achha, dekhte hai usko. Sochte hai. NR log of V2 by V1. Okay, this is for temperature and volume units variable. Iska you'll have the application directly. Question will be over. Okay, directly used to use. They have to use the formula. Now the second case, if temperature and pressure are variable, this part will be same. Delta S is equals to 2.303 NCP log of T2 by T1 plus 2.303 NR log of P1 by P2. Yeah, P1 by P2. These two basic formula we have. All other formula you can derive from this. Right? Okay, these are the two basic formula. Third one, now you see, from this two we can write down all the formulas. If the process is isothermal, for isothermal process what we can say? T1 is equal to T2. This term won't be there, this term won't be there. Right? So delta S is equal to this or this equals to this. So formula will be delta S is equal to 2.303 NR log of V2 by V1. And similarly, you see, isothermal process, we know pressure volume inversely proportional. That also, in terms of this, you can write 2.303 NR log of P1 by P2. For isomeric process,
So, for isothermal process, is this equal to?
Yes, equal to. This equals to this and equals to this. both forms like can use. Depending upon what value is given, right? Isobaric, this term won't be there. Right? So this goes to this. Delta S is equals to 2.303 NCP log of T2 by T1. In terms of volume, what we can write? 2.303 NCP log of V2 by V1. Okay? Fourth one, fifth is isochoric. Delta S is equals to 2.303 NCV log of T2 by T1 copy of this.
Isobaric temperature is
going to
be
where?
This one?
Yeah, for isobaric, yeah.
Isobaric pressure is constant. This term will be zero. We are not writing it down with the help of this. With the help of this formula, we wrote this.
Yeah.
Now the pressure is isobaric. So what we can write? V2. T2 by T1 is equal to V2 by V1. So मैंने just यहाँ पे इधर यहाँ पे CP भी है. This is exactly same. So instead of T2 by T1, I have just written V2 by V1 because of process isobaric.
Okay.
That's the same thing I did here also.
For isobaric,
T and V are still variable. That's why we have two formula, one in terms of temperature.
But why can't we just write the first formula only? So what's the difference?
No, this is.
So basically, that's the difference. So that means this case one and that fourth one are coupled.
No, no. Point is.
That
in this case, they will give you the temperature and volume both are variable. Right, all of the things are constant. In that case, either they'll give you change in temperature or change in volume. They won't give both. If they give you both, then you have to use this. Okay?
Both
then you'll use.
Oh, but they would have given us in terms of CV.
Yeah, they were CP.
CP.
But you can always find that out.
CP minus CV is
equal. Aren't they both equal?
No, they both are equal. This we have plus here.
No, but isn't that
this delta is equal to
delta
S? This goes to this.
Delta S is case 1. It won't be delta S is case 4.
No, it won't be. When the both are changing, it is given in the question. We'll use this formula. If they are given, only temperature is changing. CP is given, we'll use that formula. Right? Temperature is changing. CV is given, we'll use this formula. Like that.
But isn't here
or the volume issue? If mixing of gases are there, in case of mixing of gases, the delta S is equals to minus 2.303 R. N1 log of X1, N2 log of X2, and so on. Right, N number of gas we have, so all those will add. Well, X is the mole fraction. X is the mole fraction and N is the number of moles. Like the derivation we do not have. But if you see this term, 2.303 NR log something, right? If you see in Walton also, we'll get the same kind of expression, right? So basically, we can understand this part is the energy that is exchanged, right? So if you have mixture of gases, so this change will be there for all the gases. So total change will have, because of that only the change in entropy will be there. Because it is nothing but randomness. how fast or how slow the gases, molecules or particles are moving, right? So work done is nothing but changing energy. So energy change means what? Randomness will change. That's why the every energy change we are adding up. That's why we get this. Maybe because of that. But derivation, if you want, I can give you. I haven't done this derivation, but we can think about that also. That's what, it is a part of derivation. Why we are getting negative over there also in reversible isothermal expansion work done? We have got some negative term over there now. Right, so this is the part of derivation, that's why we are getting negative. If you want derivation, I can give it to you. Next class, I can give it to you. This negative thing we are getting because of derivation only. But yeah, again, derivation is not required. You will get this question directly. We'll see next class, I'll tell you the derivation. Okay?